Welcome back from That Short Break. You are still watching Urban Today, broadcasting to you live from the Industrial Center here on Urban Television. And you can be sure to catch the show straight out of social media. All you need to do is make sure you have some OTT as well as some data and visit our pages. Facebook, it is Urban Television, and Twitter, it is at Urban TV Uganda. Right now, we're getting into Kachai this morning. I know our Kachai conversation, we want to be talking about possession of guns coming in from LDUs. There's an incident that did happen, and we believe that this particular story we're about to show you is going to keep you updated and give you a picture of what we are talking about.
Robert Mukishanga Msubuzi yakubiddwa amasasi musse mu kiro ekikesizo olwaleero. Ono abadde mutuuze w'ekikookiro ewa Kisonga abadde avuga mmotoka ekika kya Progress nga teriiko nnamba. Kigambibwa nti Mukisha yabadde ne mukwano gwe nga banywa omwenge ku bbaala ya Timeless esangibwa ennansana ku Yesu amala era okutuuka okumukuba amasasi yabadde atutteko mukwano gwe we Kabumbi. Bwe yabadde akomawo yasanze abeera DU ne bamuyimiriza n'agaana kwe kumugoba nga bakozesa emmotoka ya buyonjo.
Polisi w'okuyimiriza si abasoma lwaki tukola ki?
Mugisha muyimiridde mu katawuni ke Kabumbi era wano ne bamukwata ekyazzeeko kumusiba miguwa naye yalabiriza abasirikale neyesumulula n'adduka.
Bamukisa motoka buyavuddemu ate yamusebusi.
Abeero DU babadde bangi baadde bakyamukazakaza awo neyesumulula emiguwa n'adduka. Kati we yadduse yadde amanye ne waffe waliyo kkubo. Naye ng'ate tewali kkubo tekyamuleetedde obuzibu.
Yagudde mu lugya lw'omutuuze era amasasi agaakubiddwa agamu gaayise mu luggi ne gayingira mu nnyumba. Abamu ku beerabiddeko ku nsasa geno be twogeddeko n'abategeeza nti olwamaze okuba Mukisha amasasi tebazzeemu kukkiriza muntu yenna okutuuka waagudde era ekyazzeeko okumutwala mu ddwaliro e Mulago gye yafiiridde.
Ng'abasirikale bangi nnyo ne tutasobola mmusemberera naye ababadde basooseewo. Ffe twamulabye kuba bamukubye ebyenda byonna ne bifuluma wabweru. N'omusaayi kuba bamukubye ennyo bamukubye amasasi ne gamuyita mu mugongo ndowooza olabye ozaalifuna mu nnyumba ne mu bisenge mwonna.
Kansala tonde kiyita avumidde ekyabeera DU okwanga abantu amasasi kuba omugenzi yabadde mubbi.
Babulamu okuteekateeka nti n'okufulumya essasa limu okuba bakinyumirwa bunyumirwa. Nkivumirira, nkivumirira, nkivumirira.
Ng'abakulembeze b'e Kabumbi batulambuzza bwe baakubidde Mukisha amasasi nga ye emmotoka yeesikiddwa ku siringi n'etwalibwa ku poliisi ennansana. Tutuuseeko maka ga Mukisha agasangibwa ekikookiro mu Wakiso ne tusanga ng'abenganda bakuŋŋaanyira ne batubuulira ebikwata ku mugenzi ng'abadde asuubulira mu kikuubo.
Tetugaanye abantu baba bakyamu naye omuntu ogenaomutambulirako omanya ekituufu oluvannyuma naye ekyokutuusi tekikola makulu.
Kati tunuulira abaana nga bano abaana abato omukyala aba atandikirawo era asigaddewo.
Yatugambye agenze kulaba mupiira naye twazzeemu okufuna amawulire ku ssaawa 7 gw'ekiro.
Bano bamulisizza abaana bataano ne Namwandu. Omwogezi w'ekibinja ekisooka ekya UPDF Meeja Birali Katambala budde baddereeva abeesigiriza okuyimirira ekiro ng'abeebyokwerinda babayimiriza.
Siraba mu nsonga lwaki omuntu atali mumenyi w'amateeka yandivuze emmotoka ekiro nga teriiko namba puleeti. Kuba namba puleeti yeyamba okulaba nti emmotoka kikabwe namba bweti ne bweti ne bweti. Nnyo okuvuga ku ssaawa ezo abasirikale bakuyimiriza. Tuyimiridde bakwekiise mu maaso ovuddemu odduse bakubye amasasi abiri mu maaso era n'osigala ng'odduka kiragira ddala nti bumenyi bw'amateeka bwe bwabaddewo.
Abubatuusa yakusakidde gwe nkula.
There you have it, of course, an incident that did happen down in Nansen. Now, first things first, we understand that these local defense unit personnel were given guns after the training in order to help and curb on, the insecurities that did happen in the country. But my first question here is, does an LDU personnel have the right to stop you when you're driving your vehicle?
Yes, why not?
I thought it was supposed to be just the traffic officers.
No, there are places where there's no traffic officers. Mm. And, you know, the security personnel can stop you for different reasons. Mm. So it does not mean that, you know, once you get into a car, no one else can stop you.
Mm-hmm.
Even a citizen can stop you.
Mm.
And once you stop and, you know, you're breaking a certain law, a citizen can also arrest you. That's what they call
citizen's arrest. Mm.
Yes, so there's that conversation that, you know, an LDU cannot stop you when you're driving.
Mm.
Why not? You see, you just have to measure. Why are you being stopped? Where are you? Which part of, Uganda are you? What are you doing? What's going on? What's a security standard there? What's happening generally in life there? You find that there are some places where there is only one security guy and like five army guys. You know, it depends on the security levels there and what they are looking for and what's happening. So it's, if you as a driver see that where they are stopping you from is not a good place, you're at liberty to drive far up in front and look for a secure place, probably a place where there are many people, and stop. Because this is security personnel, they want something from you. Unless, of course, it's a roadblock where you want to go past the roadblock, so you have to stop. But yeah, an LDU or an army person, a police officer, a traffic person, they can stop you for whatever reason.
Okay. Tina, what do you make of the story? Gentleman was stopped, you know, after having some good times with a friend, and, you know, he did not respond to the stopping. The next thing, after the LDU grabs him, time around, he manages to find a way of, you know, letting the ropes around him be free, and he started running. Eventually, they shoot at him, causing him to lose his death.
One, there's so many, there's so many variables to this story. One variable he has explained, yes, a security personnel can stop anybody. Two, he had no license plates on, which even makes it more urgent for a security personnel to stop
you. Because
say if you committed a crime in that car, there would be no way of tracking the offender. So yes, I believe LDU had the right to stop a moving vehicle that actually didn't have license plates. And I probably it was going to go like, where are your license plates? Why don't you have license plates? Then the other question I have, we don't know if those questions were even asked, but how did it escalate from stop this man to tie him and bound him with ropes like a common thief? There, that is where I'm like, I have a feeling, I don't have a feeling, it is a fact, it is known. When these LDU people are passed out, they are not even given enough time to understand how to arrest somebody, when you can arrest somebody, why are you using ropes on me? They're supposed to be cuffs. You get what I'm saying? Even if it were me, and you stopped me and bound me and gagged me without any explanation, I would want to run for my life. Now, let's put also the other variable that as Ugandan citizens, the last thing you're going to trust is a security personnel. Let it be a cop, let it be an LDU, let it be an army person. Because one, we know it, when they stop us during the night, it's always about some bull. They want kitu kidogo. So we just don't want to see them. Now, when you put all those variables together, ladies and gentlemen, I feel the conversation should not just be about LDU arresting, because their conversation needs to really, really be had. I don't even believe they were trained enough in any other, in any circumstances to be with guns. Because if you've undergone training for only 3 months, we don't even know your psychological being. How is that affected by what you have gone through? And are you allowed to have a gun at this time of your life? Because some people are itchy trigger fingers. You get what I'm saying? So the conversation should not just be about what LDU did wrong, but the conversation should also be about us, Omuntu wabulijjo, a citizen. Understand, knowing your rights is not just about knowing your rights. As we just zimanya, but because TIA, you can read your rights out to a police officer or even any security personnel, and they'll be like, shut up, enter there. But it's good to also still know them. But most importantly, twefe konga abantu, your life, it's only you who is going to value your life. If they're going to stop you in such a manner, and you can already see most of these people are actually using substances, and that's something people are scared to say. I have met three LDU guys along, what's that place in Indere? And they do the same, they're the same guys there on a daily. They are high on substance. So now omuntu gweba yimiriza chiro wozeko, look at your variables. If it means eating some humble pie for just the next couple of uncomfortable minutes or hours, eat it. If it means be submissive, be submissive. So that you, in the long run, have to know my life is much more valuable than me exchanging with these people. But most importantly, the biggest conversation we need to have is with this government, it's with these security agencies to explain to us the level of trust they have in people they have only drafted for 3 months and give them guns. That's a conversation we need to have, because we thought LDUs mutambulana zibatu mubelanga ba crime preventers akunyizizo mukube emigeji sigada nejikwate taka. Why are we giving them guns if they don't even know what their jurisdiction is? Have you ever asked an LDU guy what his jurisdiction is? For him, he knows he's like the 10 arms of government or 5 or 3. Mm. He believes he's judge, jury, and executioner. Which, BNG, conversations Willis, really need to be had.
What do you have to say regarding, you know, what the councillor is talking about? Because the councillor is coming out to say, Bubana Abantu, Rumu just Baba Gala Kunyumira, Bunyumizi Kuba Masasi, Jabayina Kuba Masasi.
The councillor is politicking. Tell him, Gomanyo Kube Mundo.
It takes so much
hard. Getting a bullet out of a gun is a hassle. It's not as if, you know, you're
like doing in the movie.
So your counselor is just politicking. There's no one out there who says Hanimira Kuba Masasi and is shooting at people. I think there are maniacs like that. Yeah, I think that's politicking. What I think we need to, you know, in that particular case, is to ask ourselves the relationship between the LDUs and the guy. Because there must have been a relationship.
True.
Otherwise, they would have stopped someone else, or probably a guy on a border, because that's easy to shoot.
Mm-hmm.
It's a guy on a border, chase him down, shoot him. This guy is driving a car. You understand? Why was this guy taken out of the car and bundled with ropes? You understand? We might want to point the fingers at these guys that have guns, but we also need to ask ourselves some of these questions. That the fact is there was a relationship between this guy and the LDUs.
Mm.
When they stopped him,
he refused to stop the first time. Yes,
that's the first thing. Mm. And then he decided to, you know, drive off. And when he stopped, he was bundled. When he was bundled, why didn't he agree to go to be taken to police? Why did
he try to run away?
Mm. So those are things that you know, we need to ask. And I hope that the police asks before they make conclusions and say LDUs and guns are wrong, or maybe the citizens, or before we make
LDUs
any conclusions.
And guns regardless of the
do you think the LDUs should actually even possess guns
in
the first place?
I don't think they should.
Because of the demand and what has happened in the past for security, I think that the security guys will make a decision and we ought to respect it. You understand? Because for them, they look at security with intelligence. Mm. For us, we look at security with logic. There's a difference. For us, you think, because logic is around you. You understand? You say, may I stay in Kulambere? It's like this, why should an LDU have a gun?
Mm.
But the guy who's, the security agencies have intelligence in that area. They know probably,
which was very scary, at 9 p.m.
And they shot them dead.
But it wasn't LDU.
But the world is safer from two people.
Mm.
So the conversation shouldn't be about whether we should give LDUs or traffic officers or whatever guns. The conversation should be, these people we are giving guns, whether it's the army guys, LDUs, or police officers, have they been trained to handle a gun? And do they know how to handle a gun? There have been incidences in the city where, you know, a guy is seated and the gun is looking where it wants, and boom, a bullet goes off. Mm-hmm. You understand? Mm-hmm. So the question should be, are these guys trained? Just this morning I was coming, that guy is coming from home with a gun. He was a security guy from one of these companies. Why do we have guns being given to guys who earn less than the cost of a gun to sleep with a gun?
Thank you.
You understand? Guy afune mtwalo mukaga, emundu ya sente nyinji nyo milioni tano.
Which means wabanga yagala jiwere bukadde busapa tunuzabu.
So do you think we're going to go back to the other conversation of, you know, who should be having a gun and, you know, what are some of
that conversation
the qualifications
is there,
for someone to have a gun?
Should always be there.
That conversation is always there. There's no such a time where we shall not be having the conversation of, should this guy have had a gun? That one will always be there. But we need to minimize.
Mm-hmm.
We need to, the security agencies need to minimize. And I think Papa Colib, more fresher courses when they're giving these guys guns, I don't know. Because like it or not, we need the security.
There are
times when these guys have been able to help us.
Mm-hmm.
Or maybe we are paying the wrong sectors wrongly. Because you find a guy who is a general, earns this amount of money, gets these allowances, stays in a built house, and earning a lot of money.
Mm.
But you find a guy who's sleeping on the road, sleeps in a ghetto, probably has no lunch, but earning very little money. So probably misappropriation of fundings. Yeah, when you go to probably other countries, you find that the teachers, the nurses, and what, they earn more money.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, at Waga, Wagendo Kube Cheyo, that if you become a nurse,
That's where the money is at. Not doctor, but nurse.
So here we also need to think and, you know, re-strategize and pay these guys a little bit more money, or probably. Otherwise, its discipline is going to increase and increase and increase.
Mm-hmm.
All right, it's very unfortunate that Mujisha had to lose a life, and we do hope that, you know, God manages to, you know, help the family as far as this particular one is concerned. In case of more details, we'll definitely keep you informed. The conversation still goes on social media. Do you think that it's okay for the LDUs to have guns with them as far as, you know, them maintaining a peace, security and order is concerned? Right about now, we're going for a very short break, but when we do get back, it will be the second hour, and we'll be getting straight into the love letter this morning.